Okay, our studies today is going to be on a topic of, or which teaches a form of godliness or a form of religion. And our verse for that topic is 2 Timothy 3:5, which says, having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. In Swahili,
wenye mfano wa utaua, lakini wakikana nguvu zake, hao nao ujiepushe nao.
That is it. So, it is a long topic, but we are going to go slowly by slowly, bit by bit, so that people may hear or may see what is this form of godliness. One thing, a form of godliness must come from something which is real. There must be something before a form which is the real one. You see now, you cannot have a form of religion without, and you cannot have a form of religion without having been there a real religion. So, which means a form of religion cannot be there if there were not that first true religion. That is it. Sinquely. But the first one can be. So if you are going to have the first one, which is the real religion, so this is the first religion, is the one which derive and a form. So we can have, there is a way we can have a form of religion without having the true one, which in the first inception must be there. But we are going to see that we need, for a true Christian, need to have that which is the spiritual and again the form. You must have both. But you will find that in most cases, people take a form and they discuss or disregard the original. So you understand as we are going on. So, men make a great show of religion and yet be very destitute of the power of it. That means we can have a form of religion and yet the power of that religion is not with us. Tuko na mpango ama mfano wa uteua. Tuko na mfano wa uteua. Na tuko na mpangilio sana wa huo utaua ukionekana kwa macho ya mwili. Lakini the power ile inatakiwa kuambatana na hiyo huo uteua haimo. The power haiko. So that's what we want to understand, to study, so that we understand truly what it means to have a form of religions without the power. So, having a form of godliness but denying the power thereof. It's a simple statement. When Apostle Paul talked about it, but it carries a weighty matter of religion, as we are going to see by and by. If you read Romans 2:17, 20 and 21, Hebu soma.
Nasema. Lakini wewe ukiwa unaitwa Myahudi na kuitegemea Barabi na kujisifu katika Mungu. 17 imesha.
20.
Mkufunzi wa wajinga, mwalimu wa watoto wachanga, mwenye namna ya maarifa ya maarifa na ya kweli katika Torati. Basi wewe umfundishaye mwingine, je, hujifundishi mwenyewe? Wewe uhubirie kwamba mtu asiibe, waiba mwenyewe.
Hebu soma kwa Kiingereza. Read in English.
Nasema. Behold, thou art called a Jew, and restest in the law, and makest thy boast of God, an instructor of the foolish, a teacher of babes, which has the form of knowledge and of the truth in the law. Thou therefore, which teachest another, teachest thou not thyself? Thou that teachest a man should not steal, dost thou steal?
Yes, you see now, these were the Jews. They were the teachers of the law. Ni kweli? We have the scribes. We have the Pharisees. And by they were pastors of that time. But apostle here is telling them, you that teaches others, you have a form of law. A form of law. Sidio? Or a form of truth. Because of what? Because you teach others, but you don't teach yourself. Sijui kama tunasikia? You teach others, you have a form of teaching, because you say, we are teachers. Because you say, we are pastors. You have taken that seat. But how come that you have a truth through you are teaching, because they were teaching the law of Moses, but then your practice is not in line with what you are teaching. Yeah. Yale mnafundisha hayabatani na kulingana na vile nyinyi mko. Kwa sababu unaambia wengine wasiibe, lakini nyinyi mnafanya nini? Mnaiba. How are they stealing? Hata kuna pahali walikuwa naambia watu walete pesa ndio wafanyiwe jambo fulani. Tuliona even brokering katika synagogue. Si tuliona in Jerusalem. Sorry. In Jerusalem temple. Wanafanya ubroker wa pesa. So that way they were stealing. Because stealing haimaanishi wakati tu naenda kuiba pesa directly. When you look at the word stealing spiritually, it is very deep. A pastor wakati anakuambia utoe pesa utabarikiwa, na he is not sure of that baraka, anakuambia kitu ambaye kabisa kabisa he is not sure of. That is stealing. That is stealing. Mwanake anakuambia kitu, he is teaching a law, because anakuambia is the truth, but that truth, he knows truly, cannot work. He cannot work. Anajua kabisa inside his heart, that the truly, hata yale yote anakuambia, haitafanyika. Haja yake ni nini? Ni pesa. So, he has a form of truth, without what? Without the power. Manake, ni wangapi wamebarikiwa? Ati wanaambiwa ati utapata sijui nini. Ni wangapi iko? Hakuna. Kwa hivyo, hivyo hapo tunasikia, Wayahudi walikuwa the same. Sasa pona, behold thou art called a Jew, and restest in the law, and has the form of knowledge, and of truth in the law. Thou therefore that teachest another, teachest thou not thyself? Thou that preachest a man should not steal. Dost thou steal? Wewe ambaye unafundisha watu wasiibe. Wewe unaiba. Umejitukuza spiritually na unaona uko sawa. So, a form of religion, it is that way where people teach something they know. They purport that thing to be truth, but they don't teach themselves with that truth. So a form of godliness signifies an empty show and profession of religion without the real effect of it. Tumepatana hapo sasa? Nitarudia. A form of godliness signifies an empty show and profession of religion without the real effect of it. Nikusema, is a profession of religion, mtu ambaye anaonekana ni kana kwamba yeye ni Mkristo. Sisemi mapasta peke yao, sisemi ati hii na apply kwa wale wale wanafundisha. Hata wenye wanafundishwa, as we are going to see, hata wenye wanafundishwa, kama yale unaifundishwa, unayasikia, lakini you don't act the, yani, in accordance with the power of that word. Even you yourself, you have what? A form of godliness, ama a form of religion. See now? So, they who are destitute of this, the power, are said to deny the power of religion. See now? So, those people, ambaye kabisa kabisa they have a form of godliness, they are said to deny the power of that religion. So, men are said to contradict or deny anything when they do contrary to what they pretend. Tunaelewana? Men are said to contradict or deny anything when they do contrary to what they pretend. You deny it. When you do contrary to what you pretend, you are pretending to be somebody. You are pretending to be a pastor. You are pretending that you are Christian. Whether you are holier than thou. But there are things that you do contrary to what you pretend. You see now? So what is openly, or what you preach, or what you are, it is a form, but not the truth. Because you are, you talk of something, but you do the opposite. Tutakuja kuona mambo mazito sana kuona kwa nini even these preachers ambao wanaongea uongo, why they sweat when they are preaching. Utashangaa kwa nini unakuta wao wana sweat sana. Wakati wanafundisha tu kwa sababu they pretend what they are not. They use a lot of energy because they are hiding themselves behind a certain truth, but it is not the truth because they are not that way themselves. Nalwana, if you read Titus 1:16, inasema namna gani? Titus 1:16 inasema, they profess to know God, but in their works they deny him. They profess to know God, but in their works they deny him. Kiswahili?
Kiswahili nasema, wanakiri ya kwamba wanamjua Mungu, bali kwa matendo yao wanamkana. Ni wenye machukizo, wahasi, wala kwa kila tendo jema hawafai.
That is it. Na hapa ndio niliwaambia, nikawaambia, how can somebody be preaching the truth? How can somebody be saying, yani, be a pastor, but when it comes on the side of money, he cannot condemn any sin in a church or in a congregation, kwa sababu he doesn't want to offend you. Ni kwa sababu wewe unatoa pesa mingi sana. He better hide the truth. Lakini asifanye nini?
Asikukwaze.
Maanake utafanya nini?
Msaada
utakwama na utaenda. That's why we have even churches, big churches ordaining women. Sasa they see as if they are doing a favor to that woman. Lakini if they knew, they are misleading that woman. I'm very sure there is nobody, if he or she could be taught the truth as it is in Jesus Christ, anaweza kubali kuwa ordained. If only the truth was put openly unto her eyes, hakuna. Lakini kwa sababu wenye wanafundisha something ambayo is not the truth, it is a form of religion, but denying the power of that religion. You see? So, we are going to see, to show wherein a form of godliness does consist. In detail, so tuone, e form of religions inakaa wapi, ama inajificha wapi. Where does this form of religion consist? Where does it hide itself? And why many people, even today, big people in big churches, those who are so-called reverends, bishops, archbishops, they don't understand about this form of religion. It's because they trust so much on a form than the true religion. So, in general, it consists in an external show and profession of religion. This form of religion, first, it starts on external show and profession of religion. So, what does they do? Some pitch upon one part of religion and set themselves chiefly to make a show of that. You see, when we say external form, they have known in a way that as a Christian, I'm supposed to do this and that and that. Wanajua kabisa kwa sababu they have inherited some of these things, ama the form of religion, from our forefathers, or they have learned these things from universities, colleges, that a church is supposed to be this and that and that. That one they know. They have gotten it through education. A child is born in a Christian family. He's going to be taught in that religion all the doctrine of that religion. That child is going to grow in that religion. And he's going to know a lot about that religion. Atajua mengi sana about that religion. Na atajua kabisa, there is a time that you reach this age, you are supposed to be baptized, you are supposed to do this. After this time, you are supposed to take the Lord's Supper. All these things, each and every person in the world, if he is educated in any church or in any college, he'll know them. True? That's true. Anybody. This is just a learning in the university. Somebody can study Christian faith and he know most of these things. So having known this, all this Christian religion through education, many remain there, thinking that now, because I was baptized when I was a child by my mother or my father, then I belong to Christ and I'm going to heaven. That's all. That's all. And that's why you see, why do we have differences in this world in different denominations? We have so many denominations. If Christian religion of our Lord is one, and it teaches just one way of going to heaven, why so many ways? Did you come to the one? Why so many ways? Why so many denominations with the different teachings? Each having a certain part, another one having a certain part which is not there with the other people. Why? Why do we have all that? It is because these churches, they never mind about the true religion. They never mind about it. They never. Nobody wants to know actually what is Christian faith. So those who inherit these churches, they just want to continue with a form. With a form, without even understanding why this form came about. And that's why we have said, some pitch upon one part of religion and set themselves chiefly to make a show of that. You'll find that different denominations have got parts. And through that part, they want even to show themselves they are more than other people. So you go and meet them. You'll see a one saying that we don't do that. What do you have? What do you do? We do this and this and this. You go to another denomination, you'll see that there's a point or a part which they are highlighting more than another denomination. You go to another one, the same. You go to another one, the same. What has caused all this? It is because those people who are leading these churches, they are driving on form of religion, a form, but not the true faith of Christianity. Because the way of going to heaven is what? Is one. And if our aim is to go to heaven, and if you knew our road to heaven is this way, I don't see why we should have so many roads going, some going opposite to one another, and yet we are going where? They are going where? They are going to heaven. So that's the difference. You see? So others take more part of it, of this form, and endeavor to express and counterfeit them. You see now? Some, they study this form. And this form, they take even many parts of that form and they counterfeit some other things in that form. Meaning, they have even additions of what is not in the scripture. True? Yes. They have even additions. What is that which is not in the scripture? Those additions. Like what? You go to some denominations, like our Catholic Church, where do they get beads? Rosary. Where do they get it from the scripture? Nothing, nowhere. But you find that that's a part, and they are very happy, and they have a lot of pride when doing that part, and other people are not doing it. Some, you hear, they are baptizing children, and some are not. And each and everyone, if you ask them, we always have got a point why they are not doing it, and others are doing it. Some are ordaining women to be preachers in the church. Where do they get it? In the scripture? No. But there always comes with the point to support why they are doing it. That is because that religion or that church is only after a form, but not after godliness. We are going to see why it is not after godliness. It's because it's just a form. So that the form of religion are various and different, are not to be reduced to any fixed and constant standard, but they commonly appear in some one or more of these shapes. You see now? There are many. One, the only difference that you can see on these churches among this form of religion, you'll see what they do as one external devotion, as we are going to see. External devotion. External devotion, this is the most common form of religion and easiest to be assumed. And therefore, it is that so many take it up. One form of religion ambaye has taken people by storm, or which has, or many churches have taken, it is external devotion. External devotion. What is external devotion? This is the most common form of religion and easiest to be assumed. And therefore, it is that so many take it up. And this is good in itself, a necessary part of religion. Okay, if you look at any person in any form of religion, the most plausible, the most common things that somebody need to do in order to be seen that he's a Christian is devotion. External devotion, your own. In which way? Why is this external devotions a hindrance? Why? Because this external devotion, Satan uses this as a way of deceiving many people to remain in a form of religion and denying the power of that religion. This external devotion shows itself more especially in these two ways. This external devotion. Ambaye hii ndio watu wengi, millions, wacha tuseme hata billions in the world, they have a form of religion without that power. Because of one thing, being in love with the external devotion, thinking that if you are so zealous with external devotion, automatically wewe, you are after true God. Na wewe kabisa unatafuta Mungu kwa nguvu zako zote, which is wrong. So, what is this external religion? One, it is a frequent and diligent use of the means and instrument of religion. Frequent and diligent use of the means and instrument of religion. What are the means of religion? Prayer? Sinikweli? Fasting? Yeah? Sindio? Yeah, that is external devotion. How often do you hear people they are going to fast? How often do you hear people tell you that I have been fasting for the last 1 month? Simmesikia hiyo yote watu wakiongea. How much do you hear people praying with a loud voice that everybody, people even want to hear what that person is saying? And people think that that person is very godliness, is full of godliness. Those are external devotions. And by the honor, they mislead many, thinking that truly they are after God, but only they are just in a form of religion, or a form of godliness, without the power. So, means, we have seen prayer, fasting, even sometimes even studying without knowledge, that you are studying the word of God, but without ma'arifa, what are you studying? Even sometimes going to yani colleges that you are going to be taught the word of God, and yet those who are going to teach you, they don't even understand the substance of true faith. So they are going to teach you just a form, again, a form of truth, without the power. Because they are going to teach you theology, yani ama the word of God, just like a subject in a university, in a college theology. You'll study that as a subject. But doesn't mean that because you have started theology as a subject, you have the, that godliness in you. Even that lecturer by an accomplished part, he doesn't have a godliness. He is after what? Money. He is employed. He's a teacher. But that doesn't mean because he has taught you theology, because that's a means, theology is a means of salvation. It doesn't mean because he has taught you that theology, then you think that now you have that true godliness. No. All what you are going to come up with is a form of truth. It's a form of truth without the power of salvation. Those are the things that I want you to understand. You see now, in a frequent and diligent use of the means and instrument of religion, such as prayer, reading, and hearing the word of God, and receiving of the blessed sacrament. Even reading the word of God, prayer, even receiving sacrament. So receiving sacrament doesn't mean because you are receiving a sacrament, you have godliness. No. What is happening? You are just doing a form of religion. You're just doing a form of religion. Why? Because you came, you found your parents who are doing that. You are baptized because your parents were baptized. You found that after a certain time, after baptism, you are supposed to take the Lord's Supper, and you start taking the Lord's Supper. True? So that doesn't mean because you have done that now you have godliness. No. All what you are doing, you are just having a form of religion which you have met your parents doing it, and you start doing it just as they were doing it. It is just like a tradition. There's no difference between a tradition and what you are doing. Because now this is a tradition. Christianity has been long with us, that we are born in Christianity. And because of that, we think that because I was born by a Christian family, truly I'm going to heaven, or I have that true godliness that is being taught in the scripture. No, we are mistaken. That's not the case. All what we have, even if you do all these things, they are just form of religion. They are just form of religion without godliness in it, without power, as you are going to see. So these are not the life of religion. All these things, we might do them. We might be baptized. We might take the Lord's Supper. We might be we might be reading the scripture, as you see even in our mobile phone. When you download a Bible, there's always a daily verse that you're supposed to read. All these things, even if you do that is just a form. That's just a form. It has no life in it. It does not hibernate, as we are going to see. Why? These are not the life of religion. They are not the life of religion. Even if you do all these things, they are not the life of religion. No. What are they? The great end and design of it. Sorry, these are not the life of religion, the great end and design of it, but the means and instrument which God has appointed for the begetting and increasing of holiness and virtues in us. Nikumanisha nini? Nikumanisha all these instruments. Ama the means of religion, ambaye tu, yani, ambaye tuko. Tunatumia, tumesema prayer, reading, even studying the word of God as a scholar. These things in themselves, they are just means to the end. But they are not end in themselves. Sasa, kwa hivyo, if you just take these things without the end, without considering the end of them, without understanding why you are doing this, and that's what I told you sometimes back. Was it the last Sabbath? I told you. People, very few people even understand what is baptism. Very few people even understand what is the Lord's Supper. Why do they take the Lord's Supper? They just take it because they have met their parent doing it without the knowledge. So these are just means to the end. But they themselves, they are not the end. So a form of religion is taking the means of religions and the instrument of religions to be the end, and they start there. They stop there. Wanafika pale, wanasimamia pale. That's a form. But what about the power? Which is, that power is the life of God. They don't care. And those who care, they are deceived by Satan. What do? They come with a false type of godliness. And by hapo ndio unakuta utakuja kuona mapasta wengi wanajifanya ati wanaongea with the tongues. Satan wants to see people, that these people have got a certain spirit, and by is the spirit of God, which is the power of God that is in them. That's a lie. That's a lie. That's a lie. It is not like that. So many exercise themselves in this with great constancy and devotion. Pray to God and read the Bible frequently. Go to church daily and hear God's word attentively, and receive the sacrament reverently, and behave themselves devoutly in all parts of public worship. And yet, all these may be but a mere form, and certainly is no more. Where the great head of all this is neglected, and men do not sincerely endeavor to do what God's word directs them to, and what they daily pray to God to enable them to do. What does that mean? Hizi vitu tunafanya kila siku. Why do you pray? Kwa nini watu wanaenda kuomba Mungu? Wakati tunaomba Mungu, you ask God to provide you or to give you power. Which power do you want to be given? Some even pray to be given power to be rich in this world. You have a mean, that's prayer. But where do you direct that prayer, Celestine? You direct it to on the other benefit. Which means, even the means of attaining to true end, that's eternal life, you have mistaken unto this world. God has given us the means. They are there. The church of God has got everything. All these forms we are given for that end. They are just mean to make us up to that end. But what do we do? People go to seek help to pastors that nataka uniombe mambo yangu hayaendi mzuri. Mambo gani? Last month I was in the job. I don't have a job. I want you to pray for me. I want you to do this. All these things. You have mistaken the means of salvation to other goods. So, what do you have? You have everything which God has provided, but the godliness, ama the life, ama the power which God wants you to have, that one you are not after. You have denied that power. What you are after are other things. So the prayer which you pray, the prayer is a means given to God, but to you, it is just a form. A form. Just a form. It doesn't have power in you. You have made it. You are frequent in prayer. Kuna watu waombaji. Hata unaweza kuta naomba hata masaa mengi sana. Lakini yale anaomba, he is not after godliness. He is not after godliness. Mwingine hata wakati anaomba kuna vitu anataka, yani kuna vitu bado hajaamini anataka siende namna hiyo. For example, ukakuta mtu anataka Mungu amsaidie, lakini kuna mambo ambaye these are the things you are praying to God, yes, unataka kusaidie, lakini kwa sababu hii kitu ikaingia itakufinya kwa upande wako ya hapa duniani, unaomba shingo upande. True? Eh. Ni kama nani? Ni kama huyu generali ambaye alienda pale huyu Syria, alikuwa anaitwa nani? Alikuwa anaitwa nani? Naaman. Naaman. Naaman anaenda anaponywa na Yesu Kristo, anaponywa pale, ni Yesu Kristo alimponya marake. River Jordan ile ilikuwa imeambiwa ingie pale, it was a type of Christ. Lakini wakati anarudi Syria, akitoka pale anasema nitainamia, I truly I worship the God of Israel. Lakini kwa sababu akienda pale lazima ainamie sanamu pale kwao. Sasa akasema in fact but for this nitakufuata mambo zingine zote, but for this one, excuse me for this one. That's where we are. That's where we are. We don't fully go to God as God. Hatuamini kabisa. Kuna pahali waka tunajipakisia as if sisi wenyewe we can help ourselves. Sasa hapo Mungu hata kana kwamba na kuomba hii, lakini hii nifanya nini? Niachie. That's where we are. That means we have a form of religion, but we deny the power of that religion. The power of that religion is God himself. We want to look prayerful. We want to look studious. We want to look that we are this and that. But there are some things that kabisa kabisa sikiangalio kwa nini, unakuta they are not, that's not the way of Christianity. Apana, kuna pahali tunakataa. Kuna kitu ambaye tunataka kujuachia. We want a form, but not the true godliness. Sasa? So, we read and hear the word of God, that we may know his will, and that we may do in accordance with that will. And by that precept and causes of the Holy Scripture, we may learn and understand our duty. And by the motives and argument which are there offered to us, we may effectually be persuaded to practice of it. That's why we read the Scripture. When we read the Scripture, we hear the word of God is saying this, but we are going opposite. And by truly praying to God, we pray that God may change our stance, our character, so that we may conform to that word. That's why we read the scripture. That's why we study the word of God. That's why we do all these things. So that we may be persuaded, because we are going in the wrong direction in our life. The scripture, we read it to persuade us, and then we pray to God through it to make us and go in line with that scripture. That's the true prayer. Hakuna kitu umejibakisia. Unasimama na ukweli kama vile ilivyo. Kwa sababu, if you don't do it, kabisa kabisa utajikuta, you are on the wrong side of God. Wewe unamuinua Mungu, lakini when it comes to the power of God, you are denying that the same power ambaye kabisa kabisa wewe mwenyewe unasimama na yeye na unasema yeye ndiye unamuinua. Lakini unamudeny. And that's the way so many people do in various denominations. Hivyo ndio watu wengi ufanya. We pray to God not only for the forgiveness of our sins, but for his grace and assistance to enable us to mortify and subdue them and to proceed in all virtue and godliness of living. That's why we pray to God. We pray to God truly when we see our defects. That's true. That's when we pray to God truly, when we see our defect. And through them, we pray for God to assist us. That is the true religion. But when we pray to God, we have defect in us. But that defect, hata wakati naomba, hiyo defect tunataka Mungu aifunike. We are denying the power. The same power that we are seeking to help us, we are denying it. And you know watu wengi wakisema ni wa Kristo utakuja kushangaa. You just take them. Hata ni unaona wamewacha the truth, they cannot stand the truth kwa sababu they pray. Lakini all their mind is on this world. Hardly watu wadogo sana they can start wanaweza kusimamisha ukweli wa Mungu without considering mambo ya mwili. Hata kijaribu kusimamisha mambo ya mwili inakuja. Ikisha ingia basi. Inamuzuia. That's where we are. We want a form, but not the true godliness. We want a form. True godliness ni kusimama na ukwe. Na ukwe kama vile ulivyo. And to pray truly to God to help us defeat our internal defect. Ambaye not one. Na sio mtu mmoja, sisi wote we are short of the true virtues of God. Sisi wote. Hakuna mtu ambaye tunaweza kusema ni mzuri. So, this form of religion ndio imejaa dunia mzima. Not in Kenya alone, not in the Uganda, not in where. It is the whole world. It is the way it is. We receive the sacrament to inflame our love to God and our blessed Savior. To excite in us a greater hatred of sin and to confirm us in the purpose and the solution of well-doing. That's why we take a sacrament. Because we want a higher power through that ordinance. Lakini wakuja kuona, wengi people don't even care about it. Nilikutana na watu wengine wananiambia that wow, they take the Lord's Supper, they just take 1 year. In 1 year, they just take the Lord's Supper once. Safari moja tu. 1 year. Are these people after the power of God? Do they need to be, yani, to be energized in their salvation? No. That's why they just take once in a year and they feel okay. And even on that, kuna mwingine hata akimisi hiyo once ya hii anaweza kata miaka 2 ama miaka 3. He doesn't care about it. That means you don't, God has given us the means, but we disregard the means. How then are we going to be saved? How then are we going to be saved? Mwingine aliniambia, with us, when we want to take the Lord's Supper, we just go to the shop. We buy a bread. We come and just eat it together. Then that is over. You know, they don't even want, they don't want even to discern the good of Christ. I want a haja. All what they want is a form. Why? Watu wanakula the Lord's Supper. Na sisi tuende tuchukue mkate pale tukuje tufanye nini? Tukule. Kwa sababu wengine wanakula. Na saa hiyo, in fact, there was a place I was. When we were planning to take a Lord's Supper, we could plan it for 3 months. My friend. 3 months? Do you know, after we want to plan, we are going to have a Lord's Supper on December. Why 3 months? Why do you prolong such a time? And every time we are putting ourselves, we are having that. It is not supposed to be that way. I thank God because here we take it every month. And even we are supposed to even take it even after twice a month. Impossible. Because Christ said, "I'm not going to do it always, always." So these are the great ends for which God has appointed all these helps and means. And if these ends be not obtained, in vain we worship God. This means they are ordained. There are means ordained by God for that true end, that is the life of God in our souls. That's the life of God in our souls. And if that is not attained, we do them in vain. We just do it because it is just a form. Na nikuta watu wakifanya, na sisi tufanye nini? So, if we don't do it, we are just like these people. Hebu soma Isaiah 29:13. Isaiah 29:13. Inasema namna gani?
Bwana akanena, kwa kuwa watu hawa kunikaribia na kuniheshimu kwa vinywa vyao, bali mioyo yao wamefarakana nami. Na kicho chao walicho nacho kwangu ni maagizo ya wanadamu walio fundishwa.
Yes, these people draw near me with their mouth, and with their lips do they honor me, but have removed their heart far from me. You see now, this is the word of God. Ni kusema, these Jews, or the children of Israel, they were, through their lips, you could hear them honoring God. Ama, yani, ungesikia wakisema nini? Bwana asifiwe. Eh? Through their lips. And that's what many people are doing in this world. Even politicians. This word, Bwana asifiwe, it has become like a repetition of a parrot. Because people do it, anybody can shout it. But in their heart, they are far from God. In their heart, they are devising evil. In their heart, they are thinking how they are going to steal money. They are thinking how they are going to do things, and yet they are in their church. How many people we had even in this church to get today? Unakuta kanisa mtu anastakiwa amekula pesa ya nini? Ya kanisa. Unasikia mtu amekula pesa ya kanisa. Huyo ni yule kabisa anafuatwa mpaka people wanaona kwa kweli kabisa this person has hidden this money. Wengine, because they don't want to be questioned, they have formed their own ministries. Si ni kweli? Ni yake na nani? Na bibi yake. So it's a family business. Nobody's going to question him. So because he doesn't want to hear anybody questioning about the money. So amekuwa na ministry yake na pesa yake, na pesa ni yake. Nobody's going to question. Why did you take the money of the church? Because the church is his. You see now, if you read Ezekiel 33, 30 to 32, nasema namna gani?
Inasema, nawe mwanadamu, wana wa watu wako usimulia habari zao karibu na kuta na ndani ya milango ya nyumba zao na kuambiana kila mtu na ndugu yake wakisema, haya, twende tukasikie ni neno gani hilo litokalo kwa Bwana. Nao huja kwako kama watu wajavyo, nao hukaa mbele yako kama watu wangu, nao husikia maneno yako wasiyatende. Maana kwa vinywa vyao hujifanya kuwa wenye upendo mwingi, lakini mioyo yao inatafuta faida yao.
Yes, they come unto thee as a people cometh, and they sit before thee as my people, and they hear thy words, but they will not do them. For with their mouth they shew much love, but their heart goeth after covetousness. That's the people who are in the form of religion. They want to go to church. Kama Sunday, watu wanajaa kwa makanisa. They go, wanaenda ni kana kwamba ni watu wa Mungu, wanaenda kusikiza neno la Mungu. Every person, almost our country is a Christian country. That means over 70%, tunasema we are Christians. They go to church. Kama vile watu wenda kwa kanisa. Na haja hao wanasema wanataka kusikia neno la Mungu. Na watalisikia. Lakini, wakitoka hapo, wanaenda kila mtu
vile
hako. Tamaa zao tena zinafanya nini? Zinazidi. The law of the covetousness inakuwa iko ina overpower their godliness ama their will. Kwa sababu gani? Kwa sababu even they are listening to the word of God, they are not interested with the godliness. They are not. They are not. Ukiwaambia mtu kabisa mwambie, wewe omba Mungu akuondolee tamaa ya pesa. Mwingine hastaka kwa sababu anashindwa, nikiondolea hii tamaa ya pesa, nitakuwa nitapata utajiri namna gani? So he won't pray that. Manake akifundishwa ambiwe tamaa ya pesa ni nini? Ni kutaka pesa ambayo hasingii kwa ajili ile ambayo ni halali. And in fact, many of our government, yani many of our leaders in our government, or many projects, even in the churches, most of them, they want a shortcut. Ya nini? Ya utajiri. Na hii utajiri kabisa, lazima anaiangalia na anaitamani. And even many are in high offices in churches, not because they want to preach the word of God. Ni kwa sababu ya nini? Ya pesa. Unaweza kuta kanisa watu wanafanya hata election, wengine, makanisa zingine. Wanataka kuelect leaders in those churches. Na katika hiyo election unakuta even the churches themselves, watu wanahongana wenyewe, wakitaka kuhonga wewe ufanye nini, unichague. The churches of Christ. Kwa nini huyu mtu anang'ang'ana awe pale?
Kuna utamu
fulani anaangalia pale. Ni nini? Ni pesa. So, when will this person pray through to God? Hata kwani ataomba, yani ataomba kabisa roho yake ikiwa imefungua kwa Mungu, haiwezi. So nini itabaki? Itabaki a form of religion without that power of God. They deny the power of godliness. Nobody want to be godly. Hata kana kwamba anaenda kanisa, he is not after godliness. Hataki kabisa, manake godliness is going to go against nini? Tamaa zake za mwili. ambaye tamaa zake za mwili na raha yake yote ni mali hapa duniani. Kwa hivyo yeye hastaki kabisa kabisa, hata kana kwamba unasikia he's praying to God, but he is truly not praying for godliness. Hakuna, usidanganywe na mtu. Ile kitu tu watu watasikia ni nini? Ni na mdomo, ni mdomo tu, kama vile Ezekiel anasema pale, wataongea kwa mdomo lakini in their heart they deny me. Haizi kubali. Na kwa sababu watu hawezi soma watu kwa, yani hawezi kusoma watu in the heart. Kwa hivyo wengi wanadanganywa na the form of godliness, na wengi wanafuata wakifikiria kabisa kabisa wanapelekwa mbinguni. Lakini watu watakuja kushangaa, my friend. Watakuja kushangaa sana. In the time of end watakuja kushangaa. If you read Jeremiah 7:2-4, hebu soma. Jeremiah 7:2-4.
Inasema, simama langoni pa nyumba ya Bwana, ukatangaze hapo neno hili, ukisema, sikilizeni neno la Bwana, nyinyi nyote wa Yuda, naoingia katika malango haya ili kumwabudu Bwana. Bwana wa majeshi, Mungu wa Israeli asema hivi, tengenezeni njia zenu na matendo yenu, nami nitawasikiliza nyinyi mahali hapa. Msitumainie maneno ya uongo mkisema, hekalu la Bwana, hekalu la Bwana, hekalu la Bwana ndio haya.
Nasikia. Hear the word of the Lord, all ye of Judah, that enter in at these gates of worship, to worship the Lord. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, I made your ways and your doings, and I'll cause you to dwell in this place. Nasikia? I made your ways. This is the great end of all religion, worship and devotion, the reformation of all religion, of all religious worship and devotion, the reformation of our lives and actions. See now, lakini, trust ye not in lying words, Mungu anawaambia. Kwa hivyo hapa amewaambia reformation kwanza. Thus is the Lord God of hosts, the God of Israel. I made your ways and your doings, and I'll cause you to dwell in this place. That is reformation in the first place. Alafu anawaambia, trust ye not in lying word, saying, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord are these. Musi, yani don't trust in your word kusema nyumba ya Mungu ndio hii, nyumba ya Mungu ndio hii. As if nyumba ya Mungu mkiongea the temple, because the Jews walikuwa wanaona the temple of Solomon, wanaona kana kwamba going near that house ama kuitanisho na hiyo nyumba, walikuwa wanaona kana kwamba wamefanya nini?
Wao wako sawa.
Wako sawa na kabisa kabisa ufalme wa mbinguni na nani? Wao. Just because they could see this, yani the Solomon's temple, the way it was so beautiful, wakafikiria atizanza kwa sababu hii ndio nyumba ya Mungu. Sasa Mungu anawaambia, don't trust in this temple. Mukisema nyumba ya Mungu ndio hii, nyumba ya Mungu ndio hii. Asivyo hiyo nyumba ya Mungu ikiwa namna hiyo itawaokoa.
Hey, mwalimu. Ni kama naonanga kama kesho pale kwangu. Watu wanakujanga, bora tu afike kwa gate, kwa ile kanisa. Afike tu kwa gate. Milango si imefungwa. Bora tu hapo hapo kwa gate. Ibada inaendelea ndani ikiisha, unaona mtu anarudi amemaliza kanisa.
That is it. Kanisa, mjengo, kama wakati huu, majengo za mawe, ambaye haziwezi kulinganishwa na the temple of Solomon, lakini the Jews were rebuked. Musiwe unasema nyumba ya Mungu ndio hii. Asifu nyumba itawaja nini? Itawakoa. So watu wengi hata wakati huu wanasema kanisa letu, tunajenga kanisa kubwa sana, na pesa mingi sana. Sasa asifu nyumba ya mawe, hata wakijenga milioni ngapi itafanya nini? Itawakoa. No. You might build a very big house in a cost millions and billions, and yet what you are going to have in that house is just a form of religion. But you are going to, and you deny the power of the religion because you don't know. So wakaambiwa, trust not in your lying words, because they are lying words. Wakati watu wanasema nyumba ya Mungu ama hekalu la Mungu ndio hii, those are lying words. 4 For if you thoroughly amend your ways and your doings, if you thoroughly execute judgment between man and his neighbor, if you oppress not the stranger, the fatherless, and the widow, and shed not innocent blood in this place, neither walk after other gods to your heart, then will I cause you to dwell in this place. Hivyo kumaanisha nini? God is calling always for reformation in the heart of people. Wanaambiwa sasa, kama nyinyi hamuta oppress the poor, kama hamuta kuwa na wizi katikati yenu, to oppress the poor, mtu anaweza kufikiria, to oppress the poor ni wakati anaenda, ana oppress watu ambaye hawana kitu. Lakini we have politicians today, ambaye kabisa kabisa wamepatiwa jukumu in the government. Wasaidie, wa manage for the poor. Lakini they still the poor. So tuambia they are oppressing the poor, they would agree. Wataona kana kwamba wao wanawaambia hivi. They oppress the poor kwa sababu gani? When umpatiwa jukumu, you uplift the life of those poor. Wakati unafanya, una embezzle the money, then you are oppressing the poor. That's the way the Jews were. So wanaambiwa, wacheni kusema nyumba ya Mungu ndio hii. Kama vile tuko na watu wanasema, tunaenda kujenga nyumba ya Mungu. Wanaiba pesa, alafu wanaweza kusema ati, we are going to build God house. Ama wanaenda harambee za kujenga manyumba. And yet, on the other side, hii pesa ambayo unaleta hapa kwa kanisa, umeoppress the poor somewhere. Lakini wewe, wakati unaenda kanisa, unasema, naenda kanisa na Mungu. Hivyo ndio wanaume walikuwa wanafanya. Sasa wanaambiwa, don't lie unto yourself. Yani msiongee uongo ndani yenu kwa sababu, hauwezi kuwa unafanya opposite, alafu unakuja unasema, nyumba ya Mungu ndio hii. Nyumba ya Mungu ndio hii. You are lying to yourself. Hakuna kitu kama hiyo. Wewe kabisa kabisa, wewe kama hutafanya vile Mungu anasema, you have no godliness in you. So this is to declare that the mock, this is to declare that we mock God under a pretense of serving Him. Or else that we believe that God whom we worship allows these abominations and is pleased with them. Unaelewana? Hii ni kusema nini? This is to declare that we mock God under pretense of serving Him. Wakati wewe una oppress the poor, unafanya mambo ya uongo, wengine wanadanganya watu kwa makanisa ati watabarikiwa na mali ya dunia. Mpaka kuna mtu kabisa anaweza kosa kupatia mtoto wake chakula kumlea maziwa. Areta kanisani kwa sababu anaona even because he is poor. Maybe ni kwa sababu afanye nini? Atoi. Sasa yeye anaweza hata kusema I'm going to deny my children school fees. Nipeleke nani? Pastor. Labda akikula mambo yako itafanya nini?
Itakuwa sawa.
Mimi I believe that. What about akipeleka pesa kwa hiyo pastor? Pastor atafanya nini? Atamwambia hapana. Anamchukua pesa, anamwambia wacha nikuombee mambo yako iwe mzuri. Na wewe unaenda nyumbani ukiwa very happy sasa umeombewa. Mama ikikataa kwenda mzuri tena unatafuta njia nyingine urudi unaambiwa labda kuna mambo mengine wewe umekosea na ni uongo. So you keep you know how watu they are stealing from the poor. They steal from the poor ambaye hawaelewi. Poor in this world necessity. And then poor in knowledge. Ambaye kabisa hawajielewi na hawaelewi kabisa. Yani hata ukweli unaenda na mdagani. Hawa watu wamekuwa kabisa ni chakula cha wahubiri wengi. Ambaye kabisa kabisa they take their advantage because these people don't understand what is the truth. Hiyo ni makosa kubwa sana. So this is to declare that we mock God under pretense of serving Him. Or else that we believe that God whom we worship allows these abominations and is pleased with them. Nikana kwamba sisi tunachukua Mungu nikana kwamba anakubaliana na uovu yetu. Na ndio unaona some preachers anaenda anaambia anaongea asif yeye wakati anadanganya a negro person ambaye hajui ukweli anamwambia wacha niongee na Mungu. Huh? Akuja kusaidie. You see? Huyu mtu anaona ni kana kwamba huyu this person has got a certain power that is going to command heaven. Mambo yake atafanya nini? Iwe sawa. Na because this person is a yani is a ignorant person, hajui, anakubaliana. And this person take that advantage. Ya kumaliza yeye. Okay, others make this form of external devotion yet more complete by curious and nice regard to the modes and circumstances of performing the duties of religion. This external religion, kuna wengine wanaangalia the devotions ya wakati vile watu wana perform hii kazi of salvation. What do they do? They are very punctual and exact in all their courage and gestures, as if they minded nothing else but the outward part of religion. Kwa hivyo, kama utaangalia external devotion, kuna watu, they are very punctual. Kwa kufanya haya mambo external. Kama ni kuingia kanisa, unakuta anaweza kuingia. Wengine anajua kabisa, ikifika saa 11, kuna maombi anaomba watu wasikie. Maombi makubwa sana, anaombea watu ndio wasikie naomba. Kuna mwingine anafikiri akifanya haya mambo, yani he is very punctual. Katika kufanya haya mambo yanaonekana, hawezi kumkosoa. Unaelewa? Hii mambo inaonekana hivi, hawezi kumkosoa. Ukisema ni kwenda fasting, yeye hata ndiye anaweka gari mafuta. Mwende mkafanye nini? Mkafast. Mkisema ni kutoa, unakuta yeye ni namba moja ya kutoa. Anatolea Mungu. Ni sawa? Lakini yote ukifanya without the proper knowledge, not using all these things as a mean to attain the true godliness, is a form of religion without the power of God, and is vain religion. Haina kitu. Is empty. Mungu akubebelezi ya kuambie, unajua kuna watu wanafikiria ati because wewe unatoa in the name of God, ati unatoa sana, unafikiria ati God is going to respect you because ati unatoa without knowledge. Hakuna kitu kama hiyo. Because kama ungekuwa na knowledge ya kutoa, haungepatia mtu ambaye who has no knowledge of God na anajifanya yeye ni mwalimu. So umesikia pale wawili wakiambiwa, ni nyinyi ambaye mmejifanya wakufunzi walimu. Bona hamjajifanya nini? Bona nyinyi wenyewe hamfanyi nini? Hamjifundishi? Si tumeambiwa? Sasa kama wewe utapelekea mwalimu kama huyo ambaye Biblia inasema anajifanya mwalimu, a form of truth, ako na a form of truth, na wewe unampelekea pesa akule, kama Mungu anamwambia mbona wewe hujajifundisha ndio ufundishe wengine, na huyo ndio unapelekea pesa yako. Kwa hivyo ni kumaanisha nini? Hata ukitoa, hata utoe milioni ngapi, bila Mwenyezi Mungu ni nini? Ya Mwenyezi Mungu ni nini? Ni bure. Hakuna kitu umetoa. Ni kwa sababu umetoa without knowledge. Yule amekula. Na yule amepatiwa bado hata yeye. Hakuna kitu amepata, manake all what is going to come out with this external life ndio atafaidika na pesa ya maskini. Lakini mbinguni hatafanya nini? Hataiona. Na tena yeye kwa kupigwa, atapigwa na viboko mingi sana. Tutakuja kuona. You see now? No, but that great humility and liverence does very become men in their address to God. But then we must be sure that this external reverence be a signification of the inward and real devotion of our minds. Humility. Unaweza angalia mtu mwingine ananyenyekea, humility. By nature yeye awe ni mtu wa kunyenyekea. Sasa unafikiria hiyo kunyenyekea kwake it is kwa sababu anapenda Mungu. No. Kuna watu wanaweza kunyenyekea sio kwa Mungu, ndio kwa nani? Kwa binadamu. But the heart yake, hata akinyenyekea kwa binadamu akionekana yeye ni mnyenyekevu. He has humility, but his heart is far from God. That is a culture ambayo amekuta wazazi wake wakifanya. Kuna watu hata nasikia hata akikusalimia anapiga magoti. Si ndio? That's humility. It's a sign of humility. But does that mean that that person is godly? No. Yeah, it's just a culture amekuta watu wakifaa. na ni nzuri ukiona. So the same people wakiingia kwa kanisa wa form wa church, kwa hivyo yeye katika humility, kwa sababu humility atakuwa namba moja, but that one is just a form. Akisimamia pale, it is not that true humility ambaye is gracious humility in Christ Jesus. This is something different. This is something different. So I want us to see all these things in their true perspective. Ndiyo tuweze kuziona. You see now, otherwise, tusipoangalia the form of religion, many people will say that, won't understand what Paul meant when he say a form of religion or a form of godliness without the power. Nikumaanisha outside devotion. So, apart from external devotions, we have what we call an orthodox profession of the Christian faith. An orthodox profession of Christian faith. Na hii, this is the type which had the Jews had. What is it? It is a form of knowledge and of the truth in the Lord. You might have a form of truth, but then it must not rest only in the brain, but descend from thence upon the heart and life. Unaweza kuwa na a knowledge of truth, lakini this knowledge of truth, it must not remain in your brain only. Ajiwe sasa wewe uko na theology na mambo mengi sana ambaye kwa kichwa tu ndio inakaa. This knowledge must work or must go hard in hard with your heart. This knowledge must move the heart into the right direction. It must move the heart in the right direction. So, if you read 1 Corinthians 12:2, inasema namna gani? 1 Corinthians 12:2, inasema namna gani? Inasema, though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains and have no charity, I am nothing. Sijui kama tutaelewana pale. Though I have the gift of prophecy, this is a very hard, yani, tough one. That somebody must have even a gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries. Nikumaanisha, even the word of God, God can even, through common grace, influence your mind or infuse in your mind to understand some of the mysteries of the word of God. And yet, you are ungodly. Some things are very hard for people to chew. Manaka, sometimes after nafika pari, mtu nashindwa, who is this, yani, who is godly? You can have knowledge of the mysteries of the scripture, but if this knowledge you have, it remains just there. It doesn't, yani, charity here represent the true graces. Charity is agape love. That is a gift from God, that love of God that you don't have naturally. Lakini by nature, kila mtu ako na upendo. Lakini kuna upendo ambaye ni upendo wa Mungu, ambaye is a gift, is a grace in a person. Sasa Paul anatumia that one as a what? As a pointer. That if you don't have this charity, that is a gift of God by grace through our Lord Jesus Christ, you have nothing. Because Emma, all what you are going to do, even if you prophesy, even if you know all these mysteries, hata kana kwamba unajua nini, yote ni bure. You have nothing. Nikusema, when he says you have nothing, kumaanisha, you have nothing in eternal life. Yani kusema, you might have all these things, and then you have nothing. Because God consider what something, when you have that eternal life, that's when God consider that you have something. Mungu wakati anasema you have nothing, kumaanisha, hata kana kwamba yote utakuwa naye. You can be a professor, ambaye anapambanua mambo mengi sana katika theology. Mambo mengi sana through natural knowledge. Lakini kumaanisha, if you don't have this gift, then you have nothing. Because hiyo yote unajua itaishia wapi? Hapa. Itaishia hapa. They won't, yani, they won't direct you. So, let's not worry about some of these things. The reason is praying. Because the knowledge of religion is only in order to the practice of it. You see now? The reason is plain. Because the knowledge, in knowledge ambayo tunatafuta katika the scripture. We don't need this knowledge. Kuna watu, let me tell you, at least for free, that there are people who have learned the knowledge and all what they want, we have heard them, is to be teachers. Teachers ni kumaanisha ni walimu. Walimu, why do they want to teach? It is because when you go to professors, there are people who are going to, yani, to study some things. All what they want is to show people what they know. That they understand my studies, they understand science. All this is a craving of nature. And it's very desirable to, yani, to man. Man by nature want to be a teacher. So when you come to study the word of God, you study the word of God, then after you study the word of God, that word of God to you, you just want to study it just because to you, you want it to be a stair to this worldly greatness. Only that. Sasa hapo ndo unakuta, even that study ambayo unafanya, hata haya yote huyu mtu anafanya. For example, niwapatie example sahihi. You will find that if you go to some university, kama theology universities, utakuja kuona kuna walimu wengi ambayo wamesoma theology. Si ni kweli? Na wanasema wanateach theology. Na ni neno la nani? Lakini, what is their end? Itaishia wapi? Itaishia tu hapo kwa sababu yeye, one thing, he can even, anaweza hata kusoma sana na asikie mambo mazuri na afundishe. Lakini yake itaishia pale kwa sababu yeye, he has been, yani, he want to be a teacher or a professor, afundishe hii ukweli. Yani, one thing, he feels good because when he's teaching, but he is not after godliness. That one is not in his mind. See now, he has the means. He is studying the word of God, but that one is in his mind, it is going to end there. So this reason, Deuteronomy is plain, because the knowledge of religion is only in order to the practice of it. And the ant, an article or proposition of faith, is an idle thing if it do not produce such actions as the belief of such a proposition does require. Nasikia? Ni kusema, hata ukisoma haya mambo uyasome namna gani, hata uyasikie, kuna watu wamesoma hata Biblia, kuna watu you cannot even argue with them. They have studied this word of God. Wameisoma verse by verse. I read some other people some times back. Kuna somebody ambaye alikuwa memorize in, yani, in FBA chart. Alikuwa naitwa nani? Nimesahau jina lake. Alikuwa memorize the book of Romans. The book of Romans. Yote from verse to verse. Na alikuwa naifundisha yote bila kuangalia. Everything written there, alikuwa naifundisha na alikuwa naijua. Amememorize yote. But when you come to the doctrine of justification by faith, he was the first to deny it. And yet he can memorize the book of Romans. You see now, that's what I'm saying. That every propositions ambaye unasoma in the scripture, it must have some end why that proposition is there. And if it's not going to attain that end in you, no may soma, then you have read it in vain or you know it in vain. Manake haikusaidii. So they are nice and scrupulous in these things, even to the utmost punctilious, and will with a most unchristian passion contend for the Christian faith, and yet they don't have godliness. Yani they are scrupulous in these things. Yani ni watu wanatafuta ukweli. Unakuta kabisa kabisa, they are even learning masteries. But when you come to godliness, they don't have. They'll go empty handed at the end of everything. So these things, we need to know them. Religion does not consist so much in nicety and certainty of belief. When we say nicety and certainty of belief, it is not something that you want to be in the religion because it is nice. It's not nicety of it. This is something to be, yani, the religion is serious. Nikito mbona takiwa uishike in a serious way. As somebody who is going to heaven and you have seen what is coming behind you. You are serious about it. We should not take it as a nicety. The truest and most orthodox persuasion in matters of religion is but a mere form of an image if it be not accompanied with an answerable practice. Let's hear. The truest and most orthodox persuasion in matter of religion is but a mere form, an image, if it be not accompanied with an answerable practice. Hata ikuwa ni mafundisho ya aina gani? Just to follow a religion in an orthodox manner. If that religion is not answerable to the true practice of religion, vile inatakikana, it is nothing. Aina faida is just a form of religion without the power. A right belief is of great concernment in religion, but then this belief must be prosecuted into the proper and genuine consequence of it upon our life. If it be not, it is unhappy for men that they believe so well when they live so ill. You see now, nobody to nabiwa, the devil also have a right faith. They believe and tremble. And indeed, none have so much reason to tremble as those who believe the principle of religion, and yet are conscious to themselves that they live contrary to them. Yani, the devil believe, baka nafanya nini? Anatetemeka. So you might wonder that even those people who are form of religion, wengine unaona kabisa kabisa, as if through their devotions, nikana kwamba they are trembling. Nikana kwamba hata wao wanaogopa. Nikana kwamba they are fearing God. Kulingana vile wana, hata wengine wanahubiri, hata wanafanya, you see, as if these people, they fear God. They tremble about the word of God, but they don't. Even the devil tremble. How can the devil tremble and yet he is against God? The same way, while watu wanaonekana ati wako devoted sana in the region, they act like devils. Why? They, through outward action, wanaonekana see they are doing what? They are trembling. Sijui kama tunaelewana. Eh? Ama hii mambo imekuwa mazito sana. Eh? Wale ambao wameshika religion in a form of religion wako hapa nje through external devotion, ukiwaangalia kwa macho ya mwili ni kana kwamba hata wakihubiri wengine wanahubiri na nguvu sana, is as if they are trembling. Wako katika raini, hata ni kana kwamba wako na uoga sana, hata wanaogopa Mungu sana. Lakini wao ambao wanatoa hiyo sauti kubwa sana naonekana kana kwamba they are trembling about the word of God. Hakuna kitu kama ni kama nini. They are the most against God, like the devil. Ama tu rewani. The devil, yeye anafanya nini? Anateteme? Akisikia neno la Mungu anafanya nini?
Anateteme.
Na yeye?
Lakini kwa wao, hati sasa wamechukua, shetani anaona kweli yao ni wajinga kwa sababu hawajui kitu wanafanya.
Hawajui kitu wanafanya. So ukiwaangalia na macho ya mwili, unaona kana kwamba wakiongea, ni kana kwamba hii neno wanatetemeka. And that's why many are deluded to believe that these false prophets ama pastors ambao wanadanganya watu. That's why wameshika watu wengi sana. Manake huyu mtu akija kufundisha neno la Mungu sometimes vile anaongea ni kana kwamba hata yeye anaona he is running away from evil which is coming, na kabisa kabisa anaenda wapi? Anaenda binguni. He is trembling, anaonekana kana kwamba he is trembling, but in actual sense he is not. He is a pretense and he is working like his father, who is the devil. The devil. The devil also tremble. Hata yeye huaga na anajifanya ana tremble, lakini hakuna. He is against God. Akisikia neno la Mungu anaogopa, lakini hata akiogopa he cannot do in accordance with the will of God. He cannot. So wengi ambaye wako in the form of religion, they are like that. Externally, unaona kana kwamba they are trembling. Wanaogopa hili neno la Mungu. Lakini naturally, katika in their life, they deny the same word of God. Kwa hivyo, outside, they tremble. Manake, hata wakiongea, unasikia ni kana kwamba, hata wao wanasikia hili neno. Vile inasema. Lakini in their action, they are against it. You see now? Okay, another form of religion which make or which may take upon people is enthusiasm and pretense to inspiration. Enthusiasm and pretense to inspiration. That's another thing. And this is a very glorious form which is to dazzle and amuse the ignorant, because they know not what to make of it. True? Sika wama tila ilwana. Watu, kwa sababu ya kutoelewa the true notion of salvation, the devil has brought in this form of worship, enthusiasm and inspiration. False inspiration, kusema, this roho wa uongo, a false spiritual yani actions. Kusema watu wameshikwa na nini? Na roho. Enthusiasm. Mambo ya kuongezea. Watu wanaangushwa chini. Na hii kwa sababu yani watu wanapenda sana kuona hiyo. That one has attracted a lot of people in churches. Ukienda most of the ministry, if you want to win people, anawaambia namna gani? Njooni muone nini? Miujiza. Come and see the miracles. Wakiandika mambo pale wanasema, on certain date we shall have Pastor so and so. Come and see the miracles. Hiyo ni jengine ambaye kabisa kabisa, which is very adorable, ambaye Satan ametumia kuondoa the true way of worship into a form. Kwa sababu watu wengi wanaenda hawaendi kusikia neno la Mungu. Wanaenda kufanya nini? Kuona nini? Yeah. Kuona sana miujiza. So to them, this form is very, yani, is very important because they don't care what happened. Na tunaona, because ameona mtu ameangushwa without asking himself if salvation ni kuangushwa. Sasa so, ukianguka. Ukianguka kwa sababu umeanguka. Ukitoa pofu kwa sababu umetoa pofu. Sasa umesaidiwa na nini? Nini hiyo umesaidika nayo? Lakini wao hawajui, many don't know that all these ni sarakazi ya nani? Ya shetani. Let us always pay the spade. Because there is no gospel there. Hakuna, ni uongo. There's no gospel there, ni uongo. Unaangushwa kwa sababu gani? Ni mapepo gani mahaya unatolewa? And yet, umekuwa na mapepo. Alafu unaambiwa unatolewa mapepo. But yet, unaambiwa Christ amekuokoa. Na sasa Mungu atakwambia ati tena uko na mapepo, sasa nakutoa hii mapepo ifanye nini? He is imitating who? Christ. Christ mwenyewe, he had to do a lot of miracles. Apostles mwenyewe, they had to do a lot of miracles. Why? Because they were preaching the gospel to the heathens. They wanted people to know this Christ, the power of Christ. Lakini si ati kusema, in this ordinary time, these miracles, we need them. The biggest miracle ni waga na wambia, ni nini gani? Ni wewe mwenyewe, uwazaliwe tena in Christ, to be born again in Christ Jesus. Ufunguliwe macho ya kiroho, uanze kuona things spiritually, with a spiritual eye. That's the biggest miracle that we need now. But not ati mtu anakutoa mapepo. It's only Christ ambaye anaweza toa mapepo. Na alitoa na apostles. And apostles ni wale watu wote waliweza kuona Christ with their own eyes. Christ akawapatia that power ili alikuwa naye. Because they had to go to preach the gospel to the heathens ambaye hawako wamesikia neno. Kwa hivyo they had to go with the miracles ndio hawa watu waweza kujua ni nini. But now wewe mwenyewe umezaliwa na ukajua Christ na hata ukapatizwa. Alafu naambiwa tukujeni muone miracles. Nani anafanya? Binadamu kama wewe ndio anakuambia tukuje uone miracle. He has taken the place of Christ na anasema ati anafanya miracle. Hiyo yote inakuwaga ni uongo. Usina. It seemed to be something strange and extraordinary. And yet it is nothing but what every man that has confidence enough may pretend to. Nikusema it is nothing. Huyo mtu ambaye kabisa unaona akifanya haya mambo ni mtu ambaye ako na confidence enough to pretend it. To pretend in that utakuja kuona yani ati huyu mtu ana pretend in that he is promoting the kingdom of the devil in the name of Christ. Manake truly he knows hakuna kitu hata moja inafanyika. Huyu mtu anajua kabisa kabisa. Anaombea watu wanaambia wataponya. Viwete wamejaa huku. Hawezi enda hospitali aombee mtu. Ni kweli? Ukuti hata ameenda hospitali ameombea mtu umesikia tu alikuwa hospitali amepona. Wewe umekaa Nairobi miaka yote. Na wangapi umekutana nao akwambia mimi nilikuwa sitembei. Lakini nikaombewa na sio nikatembea. Ushaikuona? Na wamebui miaka ngapi? Mingi. Lakini utapata hata moja ukutane naye akwambia ati mimi nilikuwa kipofu nikaombewa nikapona. But wanafanya sarakazi in a very mysterious manner that ignorant people won't understand. Baka wanaona kana kwamba kuna miujiza inafanyika lakini hakuna. Hiyo inaitwa yani false enthusiasm. False. Maraka ni uongo. So this spirit has inspired people in an extraordinary manner. You see now, in their old time, but not now. Now we don't need miracles. The miracles already, they were performed and the church of Christ was formed. We only need ordinary means to be saved, but not miracles. In any case, those who pretend to inspiration declare nothing but what is revealed in the gospel already. The inspiration is needless. If they declare anything contrary thereto, we are sufficiently cautioned against them. If anything be beside the revelation of the gospel, but not contrary to it, then we are to expect what evidence they bring for their inspiration. So in everything is completed. The word of God is written by the prophets and the apostles. There is no other thing that we need miracles. Hakuna kitu tunataka miracle. This miracle were done in order to write the Old Testament by the prophet and the New Testament by apostles. And through their witness, or through their word, we might understand who Christ is. So apostles did the miracles, and they have written everything for our confirmation that our religion truly is Christ's religion. And through their word, we believe it. So we don't need any other miracle to be done by anybody here in between. Akuja tuambia ati sasa mimi nimefanya miracle ati nataka muone. What for? Christian true, na nawaambia ukweli. A true Christian ambaye ni mwana wa Mungu doesn't need any authentication ya miracle kutoka kwa binadamu ambaye anafanya hizo miracle akiwa na his own agenda, hidden agenda ambaye wewe haujui. And yet the scripture is well written na iko, it can guide you. Kwa hivyo hiyo yote huwaga ni external show of this form of religion. Ni kwa sababu gani? These people, they deny the power and they just want a form of religion. Ni kwa sababu haja yao ni kudanganya watu, na haja yao ni ku amass wealth of this world. Kanisa ijae, pesa sifanya nini? Sipatikane.